Okay, here we are in Component Builder at the dashboard in the back end of a Joomla website. I would like to first show you maybe the tremendous power of what it's already able to do, and then step back little by little showing you how to build a component. So I'll first show you components that I have built and how I have been able to manage them. So I've got a few here. Obviously I've got a whole lot in archive, but these are a few that I've done. And as you can see, there is Component Builder for developers. There's Component Builder for developers and how-tos, and there's the free Component Builder. And they're all three of them are living inside the same Component Builder. The only change between them is really the database and certain things that they compile, but they all are using the same admin views. They're all using the same infrastructure information settings and so forth. So really it is that simple to have one component and have it in different versions made available to your clients, and it's all possible in Component Builder by simply copying one and then making changes to that copied one. Now it links to views and all that I'll explain as we continue. What I need to do now is I'm simply gonna take the compiler, and I'm gonna compile the public, the free one, because I'm gonna use that to show you how to build your own component. Okay, so I'll compile it, which starts up the compiler and all the script, taking all the data in the database and puts it into the code that we would then need to run the application. Okay, it's done compiling. As you can see, it tells me how many lines was written. It tells me how many hours I saved if I had to write those lines manually. You can read through some of that. It's quite interesting. Obviously, I've spent much more hours on this than what it says there. But that's why these are just estimates and based on calculating the nine numbers, not really calculating the actual interaction that we've had. You can install the component if you've done it right from just clicking there, or you could download it and install it elsewhere, or you could use this URL, which is now at the moment relating to my offline environment. Once you've done whatever you've wanted to do, if you click this, it won't be needed. But if you're running on an online environment and you've used some of these links to install it elsewhere, then please remember to clear your temporary folder, because if you don't, this component can be downloaded in your temporary folder. And to show you that, let me open that website, and then let's go to its temporary folder, and you can see there is the component in a zip file. And you realize that anyone that can access this file can download it. So just that you know, I'll be mentioning this a few times, because I realize part of why you might be interested in using my application is because you want to ensure that what you do remains yours. And this is part of what you need to know to ensure that. Okay, I'm gonna run a, see it, I have a bash script that reminds me that I haven't made a commit on this, so that's just my own little script. Let me quickly do that before we go on. Okay, it's done. I'm gonna open a test website and I'm gonna run everything there. Let me just log in. Okay, so I'm in the installing area. It's basically a blank test website, just installed it, and I'm gonna use this link here. So I'll use a URL, paste it in there, and click install. It should say the following to you when you've done that. Just a side note, if you've started working with Component Builder as a free version and you've purchased obviously one of the paid versions, the difference between them is only the data that is in the database. The features and the functionality are all the same. And so if you have installed the free version, you would need to now add the database information from the paid versions. Now, to access the database information in your component, let me see, I'm gonna go to the zip file here in my file system, hold on. Okay, we've got the zip file open here. We'll go to admin, then go to SQL. Then you'd see there is an install file. Now this install file, you'd want to open it. And currently you'd see it's the file that we are using to build the database. And once you've finished looking at all the tables, at the very bottom of the file, after the tables, will be dumped information. Now with the free version, it's basically the field types that we've added, and also some, I think, help menu information, if I'm correct. I think I've added that. Anyway, with the paid version, there will be many more or much more details there. And there are two ways for you to do this. One would be simply to uninstall the free version and install this one that you've purchased. When you do updates, it will never update this information. Joomla only uses this when it does a fresh install, because that's the only time you create the tables. I didn't add this data to an install instance, since that would be way too much. And so I've realized that I might look at building a script that could deal with this, but I haven't done so yet. The second way to do this is, if you know MySQL, you can actually cut and paste this into MySQL and replace this with your prefix of your tables. But first, remove the data that are in these tables. Let me show you that. Just hold on. So here we're in MySQL, and there's the database tables of Component Builder. And if you look at our archive, where is it now? This one, you'd see that this is going to target the field types. So you'd go to field types if you're now importing the new data, and you'd go to operations and you'd truncate that table like that. Then you'd go to MySQL, this SQL button. You'd go back to that file. Obviously, first replace all those with the prefix like that. Let's just make sure we don't by accident grab the wrong stuff. So add that. Okay, so we have it like that. We say match case, search backwards, and then find. So we would replace that. I'm just gonna have it replace all. Okay, if we go back to our data, you'd see it now has updated this field there. So I would select that like that, copy. Go here to MySQL, paste it, and click go. Test her. Ah, the mistake I made is to leave two underscores in that name there. Should just be one. Let's try again. Okay, it's added it. So that is how you would add the data without uninstalling the whole component. But I would suggest that this is maybe more advanced and difficult and not ideal. So the other way would be to go to extensions, manage, and click on this manage area here and select component and just uninstall it, and then reinstall the one that you now could download from vdm.io. So once you have got it installed, it should look like this in the back end. There should be no components, nothing. Well, the free version, it should have none of this. The only things it will have is the field types, and only a few of them. Now the paid version looks different, and so I'm going to uninstall this free one and then I'm going to install the paid one so we can use that as our example. Let's go uninstall, and as you can see, it not only removes the component, but it also removes any trace of it that was integrated into Joomla, these three and tags and all that, which is quite smart, because then if you install it again, it doesn't start creating duplicate values in your database. Okay, so let's quickly get the paid version. Okay, we have it installed. So now if we go back to the component and to field types, you'll see that it has a whole lot more field types. And it has a few fields set up as well. In fact, this is the version called developer, which only has the demo component in it. I'm basically going to use this version to show you how to build Sermon Distributor from scratch. So I possibly will skip certain things because it might get too long, but I'll certainly show you from the ground up how Sermon Distributor is to be built, and I'm going to do it inside this version, and at least we have something to start with. Okay, well, that's enough for this tutorial. We'll continue with field types in the next.